So before we dive in, I just wanted to let you know that you can watch this video in your own language by selecting your language from the subtitle menu. All right, let's get started. Hey artists, you can follow the sketch process for this painting from here. Today, I'll be using my favorite watercolor technique, wet on wet. For this technique, I'll be using vermilion hue red, lemon yellow, and a shade of brown called yellow ochre. The key to this technique is to load your brush with enough water. Then spread this water evenly over the area you're going to paint. This water will help the paint spread during the painting process, creating a really cool diffusion effect. I'm sure you've seen this effect before. It adds such a wonderful atmosphere to paintings. This effect is actually called bleeding effect. I think it's a great way to describe how the paint spreads in the water. What do you think? With Halloween just around the corner, I think it's perfect for this week's theme. This week's second video will also be kind of Halloween themed, but I'll be focusing more on autumn. It might be my favorite season. It's almost snowing where I live. How's the weather in your city? Are you ready for autumn? Please feel free to start a conversation in the comments. That will also help me a lot to reach more people when you comment. By the way, when you mix red and yellow colors, that makes a great orange color. That orange color will make our pumpkin. Watch carefully to see how I make the shadows and lighted areas. It's all about using the water correctly. I'm using a darker shade of orange for the parts of the pumpkin that are closer to the ground. This is because areas closer to the ground receive less light, creating darker shadows. We achieve this by using a darker orange. A common mistake when creating shadows is to make them completely black. This is actually a very common mistake. To be honest, using white for the lighter areas is another big mistake. So how can we avoid making mistakes when shading? Well, it's a pretty deep topic. If you want, I can make a separate video about it. But for now, I can say that the environmental conditions are a big factor in shading. For example, the shadow parts of a red object under the sunlight on a clear day will have a reddish hue with hints of blue, due to the blue color of the sky. Especially with watercolors, you can create this effect by applying a thin layer of blue and then layering red over it. I know it might seem confusing now, but trust me, it's not. The more you practice, the better you'll understand. I will upload lots of video about that to support you. So I think now is the perfect time to subscribe because we can do this together. I also wanted to touch on the sketching part. To keep the video short, I chose to show you how I drew the sketch in a small window. Because sketching is a crucial part of painting. As you can see, I first outline with a pencil. Then I define the lines with an ink pen. This makes it easier for me to work during the painting process. Of course, different styles can be applied. This is just one of the styles. I simply chose this style for this particular painting. There are many different styles. We will cover them in time. If there is a particular style you would like to learn, please don't hesitate to mention it in the comments. This is your channel. That's all I have to say for now. Now I'll leave you with your painting. By the way, don't forget, if you share your work inspired by our videos on your Instagram stories and tag us, we'd love to share you on our stories and support your social media accounts. Take care and stay healthy. See you in the next video.